Sign up today.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi everyone, Basil Chapman on the seventh day, Monday, December, and we're looking at the Dow down 109 to 30,109. This is really interesting. Look, there's been a sideways consolidation for about 3 weeks. The Dow is only about 300 points, perhaps, above its high from around about November the 9th. So essentially what we've done, if you look at this weekly chart, we've had 5 weeks of slightly higher highs within a trend line. It breaks decisively above at 30,450, but it really has to break this upper weekly trend line resistance, Chapman Wave inside track resistance at 31. Let's call it 30,900. That's the level that has to break, has to do it over the next couple of weeks. If it does that, that's going to be really important for a number of reasons, because it takes us into January in a certain way. Okay. But in the meantime, there are a lot of cross currents, and you can see that in the Dow. I mean, I'm looking at Boeing really helping the Dow, but a lot of stock, Caterpillar down sharply. There are a lot of stocks that are down that are really dragging the Dow. The Dow has not been able to sustain any decent bounce so far today. Day is young. We'll see. I have a lot of questions in the den. I'd like to get to them all, but let me just go through this one step at a time. Daily is in leg E in the Dow. The weekly is in, I'm calling this a leg F, at least for now, from the low that was made back at 26,143 in October. So this is still a single leg A up, even though it looks a little weird, and you've got that incredible, you remember Friday to Monday, huge gap up. And that was at the beginning of November. So this is really unusual. And you've got a weekly C in the monthly. The only way that this is going to become really negative is if there is a closing price below 29,400. So that's about between 800 and 1,000 points down. All right? In the S&P, the count is leg F. Now, this could certainly be an instant restart. It would be really unusual to get an instant restart from this level. That would be quite amazing. I've got this as potentially at 3705 to 3750. That's kind of the resistance area in the S&P. I'm calling this a leg C for now in the weekly chart. I don't see any reason to change that. MACD in the weekly is very strong. Stochastics, 93%, just like in the daily. These are great numbers. 88% in the monthly. These are fabulous numbers. So 2021 looks like it's going to be good. We might get a lot of bouncing around and choppiness, but overall higher highs. That's what I'm looking at. Look at the QQQ. Lags, leads. Now, today, it's up 0.42%, up $1.26 at 306.78. This could have recycled. I'm calling this just to be as conservative as possible, a leg F in the Chapman Wave notation in the daily chart. Yes, it could have been an instant restart, so this could be F slash B just for the moment. And the MACD's very strong, stochastics flat at 93%. So far, this is a very good action. It's going to have to be news. Negative news is what is needed to be able to give this dark news cloud cover so that there's a sustained pullback. So in the meantime, what we're looking at is the anticipation, because the technicals still are very good, it's the anticipation of some kind of a pullback coming within a day or two. The IWM is up 0.38%, up 72 cents at 188.92. All of these are at all-time highs. Just want to check the IYT. IYT, all-time high today. Is that correct? Yep, all-time high. So everything's at all-time highs. We last saw, I don't get the New York Stock Exchange anymore, so I can't, I don't know where, I don't know what the notation is for that. So this right now I'm going to call F, although in the IYT I could say, yep, it could be an F slash B, but I'll call it an F for now. Whatever it is, the technicals are still good, slightly weaker than they were, but still very strong. And the weekly charts are still very positive. Let's go back to the IWM, the Russell 2000. And that's just saying, hey, strength has been rotating into this sector, into the small caps. It continues to do that. And all pullbacks are very minor. This is a leading indicator now. It was a lagging. Now it's a leading. Two L's. Lagging to leading. Very nice. 188.95 is the all-time high today. And it's just 10 cents under that. Now let's go to the gold. Gold is trading right now up 20, now almost $30 at 1869. This is telling us that something's going on, commodity-wise, whatever it is. And I have to mention commodity-wise because I get a little nervous about our commodity position. It's really agricultural, but it's also commodity, agricultural sector. But that seems to have bounced back quite nicely today. After the grains look very weak. So gold is up sharply, up 1.6% at 1869. The 50-period experiential moving average would be the next target is 1880. Let me double-check that. I just did that too quickly. Yep, 1880. And silver is up 0.58 at 24.83, up 2.4%. Once again, silver's outpacing gold. I like this. This is a good sign. Now that weekly chart is actually improving a lot. A lot. And we never took out that left side low. This is really important. So silver's strong. The dollar is still very weak, although today it's trying to rally. It's down just only 10 ticks at 90.72. Yep, the dollar is right on the monthly 200-period exponential moving average. For subscribers, I ran out of room. I only got 10 spaces. I did all 10. A huge write-up for my opening call subscribers. I'll get to some of that in a moment. Is this a brand new trough A, trough B, trough C, or is it a G slash C? I'm going to put a G slash C in the weekly chart. It's getting close to some kind of a bounce, but only a bounce because it's on the 200-period moving average and the monthly. Wow, that is quite a fall from 103 to 100 and to the 90 level. That's huge. All right, let's look at crude oil. And then I want to go to a couple of things here. Crude oil is up 71 cents at four. No, that's not. That was corn. Corn is up. That's why the DBA turned up. Crude oil is, in fact, up 13 cents at 46.39. Very nice. Leg D holding steady. Very good action. This is a brand new leg B, I think, in the weekly chart. That's the way I'm calling it for now, and leg B in the monthly. And that's a good sign overall. Next thing we're going to look at here is TLT. That's rallying today because the general market is weak. It's just a couple of sectors that are strong. And up $1.36 at 156.56. And as I said to subscribers to my opening call over the weekend, got to be careful here. If yields start to break because the TLT slides under 154, that's going to mean a whole other thing to watch. The housing sector, look at the housing sector right now. Housing sector is up 277 at 387.97. Thank goodness, because it had to hold that weekly 40-period moving average. Thank goodness it's holding. I'll be back in a moment. And we're going to be talking about a bunch of things that I think are very important. Back in a moment, Dow's down 125.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk.
Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Yes. So let me do a couple of things. I've got a bunch of questions in the den. I've got a bunch of questions, email, etc. Just to be clarified, this is a leg C in the monthly. The question is, why wouldn't it be an E? Because the 18,213 low in March went way below the previous starting point of 21,712 in December of 2018. So that starts complete. It just negates everything. You have to start fresh. I showed this earlier. Rectangle formation can last a lot longer than your patience. Look how long this narrow trading band. Actually, you can go all the way back here. The trading band in the 2 minute chart lasted, look at this, just all the way from about 10 o'clock this morning until 11:50. This is a 2 minute chart. Look how many bars there are. And then finally it broke down. The rule of thumb is if it holds in a rectangle formation in the high, you've got, in other words, you've got like a flagpole and it's at the top of the flag, the chances are that it could break to the downside, then revisit the middle. Just to say, oh, it was so quick. I forgot to say goodbye to everybody. And then you've got to be careful. And that's kind of now is back in the range. So we'll see what happens here. So just a couple of things I was asked about. I will deal with it. I said to my subscribers at my opening call because we've had some very good gains. I'm getting a little cautious right now. For the first time, we actually started a sector short position. I gave a choice to my subscribers, a 1-to-1 short or a 3-to-1 short. The 3-to-1 short I particularly chose because it was in single digits. It doesn't often happen that you get 3 times short. You get the opportunity to really put on a small position, and I emphasize small because this is 3 times. You got to be really aggressive to anything more than that. I'm sure that it's going to be turned into one of those 10-for-1 or 5-for-1 or whatever it is, reverse splits at some point whenever they get to this level. But I thought if we could get to it now and have it as a trade for a week, maybe a week or two, I'm not sure. I just think there's going to be a pullback here. The weekly charts are still so strong, but you can get a big pullback in percentage terms and still have everything perfectly fine. So I'm just anticipating. So we did that for the very first time. and I raise stops in some positions. I just, right now, if it looks too good to be true, it probably is too good. I'm waiting for some bad news somewhere that's going to say, hey, don't get carried away here. There's still some things that have to happen. Okay, let's just make this real clear. For the Dow, the MACD's flat. There's nothing wrong with flat. It's just that it's better if the nine-period differential, the green line, is above the red line. But look at the nine-period exponential moving average, that green line, way above it, 29,902, and the black 14-period exponential moving average of 27,736. To get that to cross negative, the green to go under to turn pink, you'd have to see 29,400 or lower, and its speed as well as price that you're going to have to see. That's why I'm saying it's going to have to be bad news. Otherwise, we could just go sideways to slightly up, but maybe not having very sharp pullbacks. But I'm anticipating, from the way I'm looking at this in the shorter term, and the way, let's just go through this quickly. I'm just going to show this. Look at the resistance levels in the, let me go right from here. This is the ChapmanWave automated resistance and support levels. Look how many resistance levels, but they're all up at 30,450, 30,540, then it even goes to 30,828 in the monthly chart. But look right here, you can see 30,241 in the 120-minute chart, a bunch. So I don't want to go through those. In the others, I did that Friday or Thursday. In all the sectors, we've got a chunk. Now, what happens is if there's really power available, it'll just take those out, and you'll just turn it, those will become support levels. I just don't see it right now, what's going to take it out. Even if they pass a stimulus bill, it's just a temporary thing. I mean, you've still got real problems coming up that you have to deal with in other ways. So that's the Dow. Now, a couple of things. So we've been long the stock, Agilent Technologies, from the 70 level way back, I think, what was it, July? This is the one that we got. We got way back in April, 70.69. We've had three little tranches taken off at various levels on the way up. And now it says to me that this resistance line, you see, it's in the scientific solutions labs and businesses. This is in an area that has been very favorably inclined as a sector favorite. That whole sector of anything technologically advancing in this particular coronavirus atmosphere that allows businesses to do what they do best. And this is one of those companies, right? But I'm suspecting that it's about to have some kind of a pullback, maybe even a sharp pullback. I didn't want to go short. I didn't want to do anything. It had a spectacular at the 105.19 level in mid-November when it looked like if it broke 104, it was going straight down to 100. Instead, it went up from 105 to an all-time high of 118.96. And that's after an earnings disappointment, which turned out to be a positive. You know how these things are when they explain it and then the market decides to ignore it. So far, this is holding very well. We haven't done anything yet. We haven't added to it. We haven't subtracted. We're just right there. All I'm saying is that if it closes under 100, it's 115 right now. If in the next week you see it close under 112, I think it starts on its way down towards the 105 level, and it's kind of stuck. It's, the best days are over, at least for this shorter term period. Not necessarily the weekly, but the daily. The monthly chart is still very strong. So I'm mentioning this. Why? Because it kind of fits in with the whole sector, like DocuSign. That's at 290.23. This is part of the 21st century. That's all I'm saying. The things that really help in this particular environment, they can come back, but they can also go sideways. Look how it's gone from 290 down to the low in the 180s, and now it's back at 233, but it isn't breaking out. If you look at Adobe, which has earnings coming out this week, same thing. It broke down. It has this channel, downtrend channel. It could be making the ChapmanWave falling X formation breakout. We'll see, but it's in leg D in the daily. But this is the part of the economy, Adobe Cloud, digital commerce. They are very important, and they are doing very well. Let's see how it's affected by earnings. But the earnings say that maybe it's still in a digestive phase. We'll see. But I'm just saying to you, the reason why I'm talking about Agilent, it fits into this category of being part of this 2020 environment that has been favorable to certain sectors. All right. Then we are along. I'm going to go alphabetically. I'm not going to do them all. So we are along the IWM. I'm also going sector-wise. I like to do that for my subscribers to my opening call. And what I do for my subscribers, I may as well just show you this because how else would you even know? Let me see if I can find it right now. It'll be the next one, this one here. What did I say? This is the IWM. Yeah, so what I do is I write this up every day. This is what I had a lengthier one earlier. This is what I write up on the week, every weekend, and every day when I can't do it. I have particular stocks that are very important that I write up. We're either going to enter and why we're entering. And then I write up this whole thing. Here's the IWM Russell 2000 and the reason why we're still long, still holding long, watching to see what happens over the next day. We're long from the 11th of November. At 173, and here it is at 188. That was our second thing. I'll be back in a moment, guys.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the opening call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The opening call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the opening call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today. If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks, we're back. So we're looking at the IWM. So I write up a big report. For instance, here's the report on my my three time frame, daily, weekly, monthly Dow. We've been long starting off on the 23rd of March at the very low. And we those were call options, and we kept moving them out to the next month, eventually taking them off at different times, 300%, 400%, 600%. But very soon after that, we actually went along the diamonds beginning of April, still long, took two little pieces off, but we're still long, and we want to stay long. In fact, that might be a position we try to hold as long as possible. So I write this up, and that's what I do for my subscribers to my opening call. The reason why I'm mentioning this is that it's important. It's no use just getting stats about how anybody did it. It's how you can interpret it. So what I do for my opening call subscribers, I have a thing called the Trader's Corner. The very first paragraph kind of sums up exactly where we are and then gives a quick review of where we are in our stocks. We've got stocks that some of them are up 80%, 60%, 30%. The latest ones we've got are even up very sharply. So I like to do that, but I've been adding more stocks than we've ever had. Usually when I get to 8 positions, maybe 9, it's almost within days of a sharp turnaround in the market. Whether or not you're long or short, it's just, I don't know why that happens, but that's just the way it happens. So that's another reason why I'm thinking that we are real close to some kind of a pullback. But you see this little doji candle forming right here at a leg D? Just make it simple. If tomorrow there's a move down or the next 2 days without making a new high above, let's say the high today is 188.95, and it doesn't go above that, but instead what we do is we go deep into yesterday's candle, Friday's candle, and we're in the 186.20 area or lower, that's just suggesting, hey, we could be in for some kind of a pullback, but look how many different levels of support the Russell 2000 has got. So what you do is you do this step by step, and you see where we go. You get your signal, and then let the signal take you to wherever it's going. It's very hard to get your mindset away from positioning. Somehow you've got to try to let the price of the action in front of you take you to where it wants to go. So just one more, and then tomorrow I'll do some more. So DBA is one that we've been long for some time. We've been long since July 23rd in 1377. This is the Invesco. This is the DB. This is the agricultural fund. So within it, it has different sectors. So it was right here, and I said, well, it's got a daily sell mode. Look, the MACD's negative stochastic's way down 50%. It closed underneath the 14-period moving average. Technically, it's gone from a sell signal to a daily sell mode. Weekly chart is still fabulous. Monthly chart is great. So I said, well, wait a minute. If I'm looking at wheat, and wheat has gone down towards the 200-period moving average, it almost touched that today and then turned around. If I'm looking at soybeans, made a peak D in the daily and all went all the way from the 1,200 area down to the 1140s, I've got to be a little careful. Also, the weekly is a little toppy. If I'm looking at corn, made a peak E in the daily and is now down quite sharp. Actually, today it's up, but it was down. I just had to be careful, and sugar is part of it as well. So sugar has also taken a big beating since the 1560s, right all the way down to the 1430s. So I said, just be careful. It's raised the stop. We've taken a little position off, but we're still holding it. So that's what I do for subscribers. And then someone had asked me the other day, would I go back and just have a look at DDD, which is what was mentioned here in the den. Yep, DDD is a recovery high. It hit a high today of 10.68. We are long. This is 3D systems from the $8.21 area. We took off a tad at 9.30. This is trading now. So this is up 8.21, 10.68. It's up over $2.50. I mean, this is up 30-something percent. This is a big mover. So, yeah, so I'm just saying, you can't expect this to continue. You've got to expect some kind of digestive phase, and I think we're real close to that. All right, let's just go to the questions I had here. Oh, I'll do one more because this is so important. The IAI, which is the broker-dealer index, which some subscribers are in from 45s on the 24th of March, hit 76.29, all-time high yesterday. Leg F, I'm calling it an F in this rising wedge formation. In the day, yep, it could recycle and it could go. If it goes above 76.29, that's probably going to be G/C. This is a leg D, a peak D if there's no new high this week in the weekly chart, and a fantastic breakout to an all-time high. Why? Because this is the iShares broker dealer ETF, and this is fantastic. This is just saying to me my thesis that eventually we're going to have the millennials and we're going to have the older folks who got out of the market in March, April of 2009 and never really got back in, refused to get back and kept shaking their head and say, Trump, Obama, and then Trump, and then they found every excuse not to get in. And then this last year when they had the 39% decline in the Dow, just shook their heads and said, I don't know. So when you finally get them back, that's when we're going to have a real problem in the overall market, and that will coincide with a whole bunch of things that I'll talk about over the next months. There's still plenty of time. No rush for that. So this is only leg B in the monthly chart. Okay, now I'm going to go back to the questions. Let's start off right away. 12 o'clock we had. Let me just go through. We had question number one. Can I repeat these? Let's see. AVGO, Vagio, that's Broadcom, isn't it? AVGO. Let's see, AVGA in here. Oh, I have this all notated. I don't know what the heck's going on here. Anyway, it's at an all-time high. Right now, this is a leg B in the monthly chart, having gone from 150s to 421 right now. So when the SMHs finally, this is still looking very good. So let's call this peak A, then a mini A, B. Yep, that's a B. Let me just double check. 384.94, 384.84. Yep, there it is. So you go. Let me do this. I'll do this slow. There's no rush. Why am I rushing? It's only a Monday. We've got a whole week. Leg A. And then it goes. And remember, this is Broadcom. A, B, C, and this is now new leg D. So you can see how many leg Ds, Es, and Fs have we got in the daily charts. And they're all suggesting that we're getting close to something. Something. It doesn't have to be a crash. It just says, I think there's going to be a little digestive phase. And those weekly charts are suggesting that we still have to go higher. I know it sounds absolutely nuts. I'm going to call this C1, C2. A, B, C, D, E. All right. So let's just call this, for argument's sake, brand new leg B, G/B. In the weekly chart, and we've got leg B in the monthly. So this is looking fantastic. And if you're looking at the SMHs, the semiconductor index, and one of our semiconductor stocks, it uses graphics for the viewing, etc. So that's holding very nicely. So this is just saying to me that until the semiconductor index, I can't say until it breaks under a certain level, because if it's still rising, that level can change. All I'm going to say is that when the SMH is trading at 220.41, an all-time high right now, give back 6 to 8%, then I have a deeper correction. There you are. Make it easy. I'll be right back. Basil Chapman, Tiger Commissions, our Dow Jones 145.
Hi, folks. This is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
I'll just go back quickly. A question I just had is QS. I can never remember what QS is. QS is quantum something, isn't it? Quantum scape. QS trading at 42.34, down 16 cents. And the question was, on the 120-minute chart, how long before do you think it'll get to the all-time high that was made just about a week and a half ago in the 53-ish area? Well, I think that ABC in the 120-minute chart, I would not be surprised if the gap, the whole area of the 44s, is going to be somewhat of a resistance just on the shorter term, and it has to overcome that. The moment it goes to the 46.80, 47.30 area, then you can start looking at this doji candle, peak D. And remember, the rule of thumb is that if you break to the – my rule of thumb, you break – within two bars, you break below the high or the low of the long-legged doji candle, there's a good chance that the body of the candle, the close, the open and close that made the doji, becomes a resistance. So that's what you're looking at. So it really has to climb above, I'd say, 46.80, 47.30, and that all of a sudden you're really close to making that leg C in the weekly. But I got a feeling in the shorter term is going to stall a little bit. Let me just look back here. There's a question about you, not you, but you. And that you is the Unity Software Inc. Oh, there's your leg D. We've been waiting for that leg D. Finally here, leg C in the weekly chart, only a leg A in the monthly. There you go. This is leg A, B, C. This is different because it broke out. So the 120-minute chart is still very positive. So this is a leg D. I hope that helps you, the question. That's your answer. You is acting extremely well. Okay, next thing I want you to do is to look at, okay, now I'm going backwards. It's not fair for those people that put in their bids early. So let me just go back there. Let's see. WVA, is that a symbol? WVA, wait, WVA, oops, don't write it there, type it here. WVA. Oh, so the question I had is, since you have different letters in your monthly charts, I guess WVA was something that was something else. Okay. Okay. ARKF. Have I done this before? I recognize the symbol. Yes. So this is a brand new A, B, C. This is a new leg C. And so that was a D, brand new buy signal right there, A, B, C. So this should still go higher, and the weekly chart is still very good. What the heck is this? Oh, FinTech, ARK. So there's ARK FinTech Innovation. Oh, that's, I had written this down before. Isn't this ARKF? There you are. I thought I recognized it, ARKF. Let me just write all these down, AVGO. A question I had about X, a question I had about SPCE, I don't know if I've come back to it, U and QS. So these are the I like to put these down. It's just worth noting. So, yeah, so that's still very positive. The other one that I don't think I did was space, SBCE. This is galactic. What is it, Virgin Galactic? Leg F/B, huge candle. Wow. Yes, it could be an instant restart, but I would prefer just right now to say this is probably an F. And let's go from there. But it's very strong. Leg C in the weekly, not an E. I think it's a C. And then monthly is very strong. So, yes, these are very sharp, $3.14 to $31.86. And then there was another one. I kept meaning to follow it, and then I forgot all about it. Whoops, where did that go? Let me just look at it. What's that stock? Laser. I think it was L-A-Z-R. L-A-Z-R, I'm pretty sure it was. Wow, up 6.82, up 21% today, 38.21. Look at that. I had this as a very interesting stock about a week ago. It's like a lifetime, $14. It's almost up. It's over 30%, 35% from there. $35. Wow. $35 from 14. That's amazing. So, yeah. So this is. I think this has got one more day to go, and then I think it starts to pull back a little bit. I don't know. I can't say more than that. But I think a doji candle probably tomorrow, then maybe pull back Wednesday. That's kind of the way I'm looking at it. Someone remind me about this, because this is a screamer. And once it's in the public domain like this, probably Robin Hood is grabbing it, it's in play. And you can have a quick trade. You know your loss. You take your loss as a small percentage. You just grab it and run and raise your stop as it's moving, if it moves in your way, in your direction. Next question is... yeah, so let me answer that. I think I've done almost all those questions that were in the den so far that I can see. So, Ms. YOLO is, whatever it is, advisor, what is this? Advisor shares, pure, oh, this is a cannabis stock, cannabis something or other, only a leg C in the monthly chart. Weekly is A, B, C, D, starts again, A, B, C. Yeah, if it's at 1702, YOLO, if it's down 10 cents. If it's able anytime this week to get to 1785, then that 1859, 200 period moving average weekly becomes a magnet, and that's going to be very important. Let me just check cannabis ETF. Let me just write that down as well. YOLO. All right. Now we're really what? Oh, so the question is, hey, wait a minute. You've got the Dow in leg C in the monthly. You've got the S&P in leg B. You've got the QQQ in leg E. You got E. And you've got the IWM in leg C. How are you going to resolve this? Well, first of all, I don't resolve it. The market resolves it. All I can say is it's telling me that the QQQ could recycle, maybe. It could do that. So you get your D, you get a pullback, and you start an E/A, and then you go B, C, D, E. That's number one. Number two is, I'll get to that in a moment, in the data question. But more importantly, as long as the technicals are so outstanding, all I can say is that the Dow, the S&P, and the Russell are suggesting 2021 should see higher highs. Just make it as simple as possible. It's saying that the QQQ, while this might be a new leg E, the technicals are strong enough that it could digest gains and then restart over again. So this could, look, this is the third month. So this could be... It doesn't happen often in the week monthly charts, but over the last year, I've seen it for so many times. This could be a ChapmanWave instant restart. I don't want to get too carried away in the monthly chart, and this could be a brand new E/A. I just need to put it there because that's my technique. It doesn't have to happen, but that's a possibility to make just a three. Look, this 3-month correction here. After the February high at 237, plummeting to the 164 March high, February high, and then March low, That was not a three-bar play. That was four bars, so that doesn't count. This does. You could fail from here. It doesn't matter. It's still. The only way that tanks completely is if the QQQs go under 260. I'll be back. Oh, there's one more segment to come. Good. I got a bunch of things to discuss. I'll be back. And tomorrow I'll be doing my show at 8 o'clock, 8 o'clock to 8:30. I'll be back in a month.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by, bam! As well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Hi, folks, this is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of the Trader's Edge, heard here at TFNN.com.
Just real quickly, a question to Dan. I made this out to be the last one right now. GBTC, which is what we are long from the $12.40 area in short-term and long-term positions from the 14th of October, hit 24.12 just a couple of days ago. It's 23.51. I mean, that's way in the 80% range, up from where we got in. This is going to be, I think, in a digestive phase. And the fact that it could pull back maybe now, and gold maybe just takes the lead because this rotation to different sectors is telling me that market is, in a sense, getting a little bit worried here. So the question also is, why is the chart of the GBTC a little stronger than BTC, which is the futures? And I would say it's only a little bit different, but the one trades overnight and the other one doesn't. So I'm just saying that certainly in the GBTC, the key support now is going to be, where did I type that? GBTC. Key support is going to be in the 22 to 21 area, looking out the next week and a half to 2 weeks. Close under that says it could go on a little longer for consolidation. Spectacular move going from way down, just in, you know, from October, from the nines all the way to 24. I mean, that's amazing. So, okay, with that said, a couple of things. My opening call, my daily newsletter, check it out. My Trader's Corner just has a brief synopsis. If you don't have time, you just want to see what's new, you can, that just sums it up. And then you just go to my bullet points, 15, 16, or so bullet points of only what you need to be looking at. And I always tell you what's new and what's not. The other thing that I wanted to mention here is that Larry Pesavento is doing his workshop on Wednesday. Check out the front page. It should be fabulous as always. I don't have to tell you that. You know that. And one other thing that I'm missing here is, yes, so for the first time in I don't know how long, we actually started short positions in a sector. That's all I can say. I mean, you do your homework, you put your position on, and we've got stops in, and that's the way it is. We still have a lot of long positions, and I'm a little concerned. I don't like to, it's just so much work for me, but that's okay. We'll manage. So folks, I'm handing you over to Steve Rhodes back. Everyone's looking forward to hearing Steve, Dave White, Tom O'Brien. Have a wonderful day. I'll be back tomorrow at 8 o'clock in the morning, 8 to 8:30.